Hey everyone, in this video, I'll show you how to design and assemble a complete cam and spring mechanism in SolidWorks. So, let's get started. Let's begin with the first part, the holder. Start a new sketch on the front plane. Press S to open the shortcut bar. Draw a rectangle sized 100 millimeters by 30 millimeters. Now press S again, choose line, and make the required sketch. Add the necessary relations and dimensions. Then mirror it about the center line. Once done, extrude it to a thickness of 5 millimeters. Next, add a 1 millimeter by 45 degree chamfer to all the outer edges. Now start a new sketch on the top plane. Draw a 15 millimeter square. And make sure it's centered. Add a 5 millimeter fillet at the bottom. Then sketch a 7.5 millimeter diameter circle at a height of 7 millimeters. Extrude it, then change the extrude start from sketch plane to offset at 45 millimeters and extrude it by 5 millimeters depth. Add a 0.5 millimeter fillet on the top and bottom edges. And a 1 millimeter by 45 degree chamfer to the hole. Now create a linear pattern. Select any vertical edge for direction 1. And choose the chamfer, fillet, and extrude features to pattern. Set the spacing to 15 millimeters and the instance count to 2. Start a new sketch on the top face of the part. Draw a 100 millimeter diameter circle at a height of 20 millimeters and extrude it by 15 millimeters. Finally, add a 1 millimeter by 45 degrees chamfer to the edge. Done. Now just adjust the appearance if you like. Next, let's create the follower. Start a sketch on the top plane. Press S, select circle, and make a 7.5 millimeter diameter circle. Extrude it to a depth of 80 millimeters. Now sketch on the bottom face. Draw another circle of 10.5 millimeter diameter. And extrude it by 1.5 millimeters. Again, start a sketch on the same face, use convert entities, and extrude this sketch by 4 millimeter depth. Then, sketch on the right plane, and make a 3-point arc with a 3.75 millimeter radius. Extrude it. Zoom in, start another sketch on that small part, use convert entities again, and extrude cut it. Done. Adjust the appearance, and we're ready for the next part. Now let's make the cam. Start a sketch on the front plane. Press S, select circle, and draw 3 circles, 10 millimeter, 15 millimeter, and 30 millimeter diameter. Add tangent lines, and trim the extra parts. Extrude it to a depth of 5 millimeters. Then start a sketch on the top face. Offset the outer edge by 2 millimeters and the inner circle by 1 millimeter. And extrude cut it by 1 millimeter. Mirror this cut about the front plane. Done. Adjust the appearance. Now for the last part, spring. You can create it using the helix or spiral feature, but to make it behave like a real spring, follow this method. Start a sketch on the front plane and draw a 1.5 millimeter diameter circle positioned 4.5 millimeters away from the center. Create a second sketch on the same plane. Add a vertical line of 55 millimeters length. Now go to swept boss or base. Select the first sketch as the profile and the second as the path. In options, specify twist value, revolutions, and set 12 rotations. Unhide sketch 2. Add reference planes at both ends, parallel to the top face. Use cut with surface, select plane 1 and cut upward. Do the same for plane 2, but keep the default direction. Done. Adjust the appearance and we're ready to assemble. Open a new assembly, add the holder, and click the green check mark without moving it. This places it at the origin, then bring in all the other parts. Now let's add some basic mates. Just select the faces. SolidWorks will automatically detect the proper mate type. For the spring, unhide sketch 2 again to see the line. Add a mate to that line. Double-click it to edit. Delete its dimension, then open Display, Delete Relations. Add a new coincident relation between the point and the base face. Next, add a cam mate. Go to Mate, Mechanical, Cam, select the cam path, and the follower face. Adjust the mate alignment if needed. Done. If it looks like the spring isn't working, don't worry. Just move the position, then press rebuild, and you'll see the spring react properly. To animate the mechanism, go to motion study, add a motor to the cam, set your desired RPM, and click calculate. It might take a bit of time depending on your setup. And that's it. Your cam and spring mechanism animation is ready. If you found this tutorial helpful, make sure to like, subscribe, and share it.